What's up, guys? Corey coming back at you here. Another video for today. The way today was supposed to happen, I was supposed to have a full house stretch and clean, but the painters and all of the people weren't done in the house yet. So I hurriedly took one of the other jobs that was waiting for something like this to happen, to come open, to put into this time slot. So I'm helping another client that I've cleaned for 3 or 4 times. It was kind of on kind of like an unsaid waiting list, basically. You know, whenever this happens, I just, I scroll through, and I look for people that I told I didn't have time. If I can't find anybody there, then I'll look ahead in the calendar and I'll bring somebody into today's time. So that way you're always working. You don't want to sit around idle on your keyboard. You want to keep working. So, you don't get paid when you're sitting around on the internet and you're a carpet cleaner. You get paid when you're cleaning carpet. So that's what you need to do, clean carpet. You want to make money. All right, now this place here, like I said, it's 2 rooms, and one of them is dirtier than the other. So we're gonna do a pre-treat on the first room, and then we're gonna go pre-treat and clean the second room, and then come back and re-treat and agitate this room and then clean it. So let's go ahead and pre-spray this room first. And I've got something in the carpet that to me looks like a stumped in Band-Aid or something, but I don't know. Well, I'll show you, hang on. This right here, whatever that is. I don't know, it's not a Band-Aid. I don't know how to describe it. It's like the color of a Band-Aid. Anyway, it is crunchy. Over here we've got, and none of this should be a problem getting out, I don't believe, and that should come on just fine. So these guys here, they're gonna get treated at times. We need this to all soften up, and dwell time is what's gonna help with this. So this is ammonia that I'm putting on it right now. Put that right there and let that dwell. And while I'm cleaning the other room, I'll probably come in here and I'll treat that one area again. That ammonia will get right up. Yeah, ammonia is amazing. It melts through everything. All right, now I'm gonna pre-treat this whole room and then move to the other room over here. So let me go ahead and treat this room right quick, set up the camera. Dwell time is your friend. So we're gonna just room it all in basically and let it set. Weird, it's got more of it coming out of the carpet now. I don't know what that is, but we're gonna get it out before we leave here, but it's looking peculiar already. was a really healthy pre-treat there. All right, let's take a look here. Yep, starting to soften it up. I think we're gonna just probably do this one just about all in real time. This room here is just your typical clean. I'm gonna spray it, and I'm gonna clean it, and then right back to the other room to finish in there. Don't kick the bucket over. That's the one thing you don't want to do. That will bring you back if you kick the bucket over. You're going to have wicking, and there's no way you're going to prevent that. If anybody ever does kick the bucket over, it's probably better to just sacrifice your fan and say, I'll pick this up tomorrow, the next day. That way you set the fan on it to blow overnight and dry it out. That way you're still coming back to get your fan, but at least you're not coming back to fix wicking. So if you kick a bucket of water over, you stand on the towels all you can, get as much out as you can, and then put one of your turbo fans on it and say, I'll be back in a day or two to pick this up. You got a helper, all that legwork you just saw me do, all that spraying and all that extension cord, handling all the stuff the helper does while you just clean. You're the cleaner. And got a deadwood socket. phone call coming in. All right, this was a total freebie. It didn't require you to actually kill yourself trying to boot. I'm gonna leave the camera rolling. All right, getting a long way though. Finished product here. Nice and pretty and shiny and dry in about 45 minutes to an hour. Alright, now we're back to the scene of the crime here. Looks like we're gonna not have any real issues here, I don't believe. Do a pre-scrub. This might be enough. Alright guys, I'm glad you got to see that. Where the hell that went? Nobody knows. Alright, now, and you saw me fix that for the cost of a couple squirts of ammonia. We got $2.50 in an entire bottle right now of ammonia, and it only took a couple squirts. Sometimes you'll see guys writing about ammonia, and they talk about how hard it is to be around and all this other stuff, and how it's hard on your lungs and stuff. And honestly, I mean, I have a problem with it myself. It doesn't bother me. I guess I've worked with it enough that I'm tough enough to take it. But I mean, if you're not, what you can do is you can take your socks here, and you can spray them with WD-40. And it'll keep the ants from crawling up to your candied ass. So that's just something, that's free information there. It'll keep the ants off your candy butt. We're gonna do a dry scrub anyway, just so it may take a little longer here. I'm curious to see when we get to that spot over there what we're gonna what's gonna happen. We're gonna see some smearing going on or whatever. I don't think anything myself. times, the longer you clean, the pickier you get. Like I'm starting to see stuff I didn't see before. So a hint of red over there. I'll leave that. Another something coming out of the carpet here. New stuff. Right now, here in Austin, it's 89 right now. By Saturday, it's supposed to be 105. Fortunately enough, this room doesn't have a fan. The one that had ammonia doesn't have a fan, so that makes it just a little more difficult if you're an ammonia guy like myself. My goodness. now, inside the closet here. Need somebody to hold the camera. All right, a little bit more room to get down that hallway. Somewhere in there was where that baked on, kicked on, whatever it was. And over here was where all that stuff was coming out of the carpet. Luckily, I got it agitated enough to bring it all out, so shouldn't have a problem leaking there. All right, guys, that is all I'm gonna record today. Hopefully it helps somebody. This particular job, I didn't use anything chemical-wise that you couldn't get at Walmart or Home Depot. So, anyway, I just wanted to add that. It's really hot in here. Currently, Challenger is still, they're having their discounts. $200 off Challenger, and then $100 off for my, you see how I'm sweating here. Another $100 off my dealer discount. So, $300 off for Challenger. Anyway, I'm gonna get the sweat out of my eyes. It is way too hot in here. All right, guys, thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. I'll see you on the next video.